Could you explain the term achievo? I don't quite.
Achievo. Embryo contains information of whole organism.
Okay.
So every part of your body is made by this achievo, let's say.
So yeah. The matryoshka principle.
Yeah, matryoshka. We can say matryoshka, but matryoshka, you know, in your hands, in your feet, and mm-hmm. and almost everywhere even in the face, even in the ear. In the ear, you can find the small human. Yeah, you can find mm-hmm. the head. You can find the spine and all the internal organs. Now that's the achievo as well. So the simplest achievo is probably I don't make a mistake. It was a morula state. So mm-hmm. you know, let's say ring beat from the small cellulars, from the small cells, all of your body is, let's say, righted in this pattern, yeah. Mm-hmm. Because
so it's holographic in nature, we can say.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. You have some diagnosis systems mm-hmm. like either iridology. Yeah, they you know, looking your eye and okay, there's a head, there's a problem with the knee, there's a problem with the kidney. Yeah.
So what about chiropractors? They read your palm. It's same principle, yeah. Or
yeah,
it's
we can
something
say,
different.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not related to health. I know it's a little bit, it's called divination, yeah, predicting the future. So maybe I'm going too far with that, but.
Yeah, you know, the face is really your head. So you can watch a lot of, let's say, examples, a lot of knowledge. That's a lot of knowledge from the head. So what next? You can get the knowledge. Is that the heat, let's say, penetrating the body, or is that the blood flow, you know, is low, or mm-hmm. whatever? Yeah, that's coming from the reflexology. That's coming from the sujok. That you can find the head, you can find the legs, you can find the mm-hmm. the arms. So yeah, that's the fractal as well. That's the achievo as well. Yeah, the embryo, we can say, and this separate the embryo as a hand, as a palm can be the same diagnosing tools as others. Yes.
So it's amazing. And yesterday I had a very interesting. It's not a sentence; it's rather a way of thinking from Jordan Peterson. You know this mm-hmm. guy, the Canadian yep. psychologist, and he said he was talking about. Subject, you know, why a man cannot find the appropriate partner, yes?
Yeah.
And he said that it's not about this question. Yeah, when you look at yourself, let's say you're single, you're looking for a partner, it's not about yourself. It's not about other people. You need to ask this question yourself.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? So there is the high resolution generalization. So at high resolution, we may say the palm is the mini
yeah.
human,
yeah, human yeah.
the eye, but actually to get results, and that's what I admire with you, you know the details, you know the high resolution, you know, when we do the close-up, and because this general knowledge doesn't mean anything without actually the ability, I guess, to zoom in and then knowing what works and how, and
yeah,
would
I
you
think,
agree?
You know, yeah, from the neuro awareness, let's say, and achievo stuff, and all this knowledge about, you know, acupuncture, Chinese medicine, you can get the solution like that. If you can't change the big part, yeah, like, you know, the liver, for example, go to the smallest part of the liver, like, you know, for the palm livers and mm-hmm. and other stuff.
So from macro to micro.
Yeah, mm-hmm. try to stimulate the micro, try to stimulate the, let's say, areas similar to this liver part, to make some improvement, yes, to make some changes. It's like in life, yeah. For example, you have some struggles with, I don't know, maybe with partner, yeah. You have to change a little bits to change all this, you know, relation. You can't take the partner. You have to change. Yeah, now you have to change. I beg you, or I, you know, I will hit you if you not. Yeah. And the in the life is usually like that. You're going for some flowers, for example. Yeah. Or you're changing some habits. So small bits. You're like, okay.
Yeah, small steps.
Maybe I will.
Big changes. Mm-hmm.
Maybe I will uncover or take the for example the snow from the car. Yeah, for her.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she will feel better. Yeah. And then she have to change the small bits as well. Yeah. So the small bits can be, you know, okay, I will make him a supper or whatever. Yeah. Without any, you know, doubts. Yeah. And that's the small bits that's changing the whole life, we can say, and can improve the relationship.
No,
and this re- the, mm-hmm. Yeah, this relationship is as well in our body. Yeah, so if you change the mini, you can make the macro.
Yeah, on the micro level.
Yeah,
I'm really, really impressed by this because I know that neuroawareness works this way. So I was asking you in the past, how does it work? I mean, I don't see
I don't know.
It can translate into being, you know, more flexible or more simply, you know, function better as a body. So for me, it sounds really, really good.
Yeah.
And also, look, our mind, I think that the more concrete we make things, the more tangible, palpable, for our subconscious mind is better, because I believe subconscious doesn't understand high level concepts like, for instance, climate change. Yeah, there's another example from Jordan Peterson. How do you solve climate change? Well, you cannot solve it, because climate is a very general term. What do you mean by change? Is it real? Yeah. What do you mean by real? Yeah. So there are so many things you need to sort out. So you need, he used the word particularize the problem. Mm. So made it particular, make it small enough so you can do something with it.
Yeah.
The same works with task management. So for example, you have the ambition to, I don't know, create a blog. That's super general. That doesn't mean anything. Actually, you won't take action because you don't know what to do. How do I create a blog? You don't create a blog, but you can write an article about a specific subject. Oh, now I know what to do. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. You know, I think this huge perspective, like, you know, you're taking care of everything general and you're going to the micro, let's say, bits of the parts. There are two similar, really, let's say, tasks, yeah? Because you have to go out from the situation to, you know,
zoom out, like zooming out.
Zoom out to have the appearance, to have the you know, knowledge about, okay, I'm like that, she is like that, yeah? Or whatever, in the body, yeah? I'm doing this in this situation, yeah? Like stress situation, I'm tension. I'm in the tension.
What
of
a beautiful statement. I see where you're heading, yeah.
So that's the general view. Yeah, you have to go out, like zoom out. But you have to fix it. You have to go in. Yeah, you have to zoom in and change the small bits. Yeah, like, you know, okay, maybe I will change my perspective by, yeah, for example, thinking about something else, or some practicing, or some small bits. Like, okay, maybe in this situation I will be not angry, or I will feel with my anger and I will find the solution in the body. Yeah. Where's my anger? Yeah, can be in the liver, can be in the lung, can be, you know, in shaking hands, whatever. Yeah, you're finding that, and you know you're going in the small bits in this let's say zoom in situations, trying to find solution for the body and mind as well in the same time. Now that's why, you know, the neuro awareness, we can say, or training neurologician, so neurological training, we can say that. Okay, you can change your thoughts, you can change your, you know, let's say, perspective of the problem by fixing your body. I mean, by getting into your body and, you know, making some micro movements. Yeah, because everything is coming from the micro, we can say, yeah. And then when you are prepared for that, you can, you know, from this micro movement, you can do the big movements, yeah. And then from these big movements, you can, you know, just enjoy yourself and you know, and have a pleasure, we can say. But the result from that is that your mind is changing as well, yeah, because your perspective of the body changed, and the body is the mind as well, we can say.
Yeah, body mind, they are inseparable. Yeah, you cannot separate psychosomatic.
Yeah. Yeah,
I think we keep forgetting about that. Yeah, focusing either too much on the body or on the spirit or mind. It depends how you interpret those terms.
That's true. It's appearing in Chinese medicine from thousands of years. Yeah, like, you know, okay, if you have the problem with the liver, you will be angry. Yeah, or you will be sad. You will be depressed. If you have the problem with the heart, and that's the, you know, body and mind connection. Yeah, now because it's you know. Okay, I have to check the phone because it's ringing and ringing, okay?
Okay, I will pause
our
recording.
Okay.
Okie dokie. Super interesting. I don't actually know how to refer to what you've said. I, well, maybe this thing, going once more back to this video with Jordan Peterson. He said, you know, if you are, so we're talking a little bit relationships today as well, but when you think, you know, that all women are bad and you are angry at women, this is absurd. Because first of all, you cannot put everybody in the same category for, to start with. Yeah. And the second thing, I think we like being right. And the hardest thing to solve is have this thought that in this particular situation, when my trauma is activated by somebody else, when they push our emotional buttons, we can put it this way, we might not be right. That's the hardest, to admit it and then to say, okay, so I'm gonna work. You mentioned that I'm gonna work. I'm gonna. I really liked your vision. Yes, you zoom out to diagnose the problem, but then back you zoom in and then you solve the particular problem. And when you release this belief or trauma from your body, from your soul, then you think differently. You have a fresh perspective, and maybe even the same situation doesn't push your buttons anymore.
Yeah, for sure. And you know, the idea is that it's not always the same pathway. Yeah, you know, different persons have different pathways to get some target. Yeah, to some let's say end of this pathway. And in your awareness, you can't say, okay, if you have the problem with the liver, you should work with your knee. Yeah. Maybe, yeah, maybe, okay. Yeah. But in other person body.
But to do what? To kick the other person with your knee?
On your liver, you can hit yourself. And you can say, okay, lie down and let's do some scanning. We can say, yeah, okay, where is the most tense part of your body? What do you feel in this part? Yeah, how can you, you know, transfer that to the, for example, feet or to the arm, or you can feel the pulsation of this area. Maybe you can, you know, make some little movements to find the, let's say, comfort state. Yeah, in this in this area, and you know, every person, every body will be different. Yeah. There are some similarities for sure, and we are showing them in the acupuncture, yeah, in for example, in Richard Tan acupuncture or Sujog acupuncture. That's the patterns for sure. But every patient in my acupuncture rooms needs different really perspective, yeah, because you know the...
And that's why you are not bored with your profession.
Yeah, that's true. Because you know, when you go in like let's say in auto mode, they will stop you, like, okay, you can't be in auto mode because I am a different person. Yeah, yeah. The pattern is the same, but I am, you know, I am pissed like never, or I'm drinking, or I'm, you know, whatever. And you have to switch the let's say target, and switch the strategy of the acupuncture. And it's the same with the neuro awareness or neurological trainings, that you can't go in the same pattern. Yeah, there are some patterns, like, you know, when we let's say getting birth, and then we you know, starting to walk up. Yeah, there are some patterns, similar patterns with all the kids, and you can use that. Yeah, if you can't, you know, imagine the result in the, let's say, human state, like, you know, walking, I don't know, 23 years old. Yeah, you can't find the solution. You're going down. Yeah, to the smaller, let's say, yeah, to the small kid solution. Like, maybe it will be a crawling. Maybe it will.
So
be
you
like,
kind of regress. Can you call it regression?
Yeah, you can say regression, and I think it's more like going in the body more, in the more, let's say, beginning states, yeah, we can say like that. Yeah.
Or early stage of development.
Yeah, early stage, because you will find there the more connection, yeah, because you know it's like a tree. The, let's say, neurological or neurological awareness going like a tree. It's one, you know, one part, and then the part is going
the branches.
From,
yes,
the branches are going
branching out.
Yeah, so you can fix it from the branch, yeah, from the leaves even. But you can go to the core, yeah. And usually, when you're going to this state of
the trunk, the tree, or even sometimes the roots, yeah.
Yeah, kid state or whatever, you're going to the core, yeah, and you will appear like in only the let's say womb, yeah.
Yeah, I go into the kid state and in parties. You can find me in the corner, lying down like this.
That's a but solution.
It doesn't happen often, you know, but I don't know why, you know.
That's a solution. We can use that. Yeah, usually.
And then when the person is at this level, you can do whatever you want with them. Kind of reprogram their body.
Yeah, reprogramming. That's true. That's true. You know, it's all about communication with our body and all about communication with our souls, really, because that's connected. That's, you know, the mind and thoughts are foggy thoughts, thoughts are connected with the, you know, with the body for sure. Yeah, you can see that by when you're doing the herbal, for example, some supplements, or when you're doing the acupuncture. Yeah, people are changing, like, you know, in hours or in a matter of minutes.
Yes, same in, you know, some alternative psychotherapies like theta healing. Yeah, you can change people's approach in hours, in minutes. What is funny, and I thought about it this morning, it's subtle changes, but suddenly your life is very different, has a different smell and different taste. For instance, if you lack joy and you heal your inner child, plus maybe you teach the person in this theta state, which is kind of a hypnotic state or meditational state, if you teach them how to be more joyful. I noticed, I did this weekend, I spent a lot of time working with other people, and suddenly you start finding joy in small things, and it's subtle, but then suddenly your life is very different. Small steps, big changes, yes, again.
Yeah. You know, I am a lazy bastard, we can say, and I always was looking.
I confirm.
Yeah, about my English lessons. Yeah, I know.
Yeah. So you don't learn this vocabulary. I put
vocabulary. I always was looking for some really simple solutions, like, you know, you can take them and, you know, and it, something will be fixed, yeah? Mm-hmm. Like quick solutions.
Yes? Ah, yeah, like a pill, you know, like a magic pill.
Yeah, you can say like a pill, yeah? So that's why I choose this kind of acupuncture, you know, this kind of achievable, let's say, stuff, because it's giving the, from the small bits, you can make a big change, yeah? Mm-hmm. And bigger, let's say, from the smaller resolution or from the high resolution, you can change the bigger view, yeah? So that's why I choose that, yeah? And another pathway went to herbalist for sure, and another pathway went to this neuro awareness, yeah? Because that it's really similar to acupuncture, to distal method of acupuncture, but you only, let's say, putting the pleasure in different part of your body, yeah, or awareness of your part of the body, even in the nails, yeah, you can say, and you, let's say, connect with them, you speech with them, yeah, you make the speech with them, talk with them,
interact,
interaction. And that appears that, okay, they have some information for you, yeah? And, you know, you're getting this information from this part of the body, you can get the information from other part of the body. And if this awareness is making bigger, in one day, you just, you know, have a seat, drinking the tea, and the taste is better, your performance, but your life is better. You can feel this chair is quite, you know, nice, yeah? Yeah, it was expensive. Yeah, I didn't notice that from the, you know, 10 years. Yeah, you know.
Yeah, it was expensive, but it didn't add any value because my body was not ready to was not receptive to that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because maybe
it's such a great thing, you know. Mm. Like there is this saying that if you cannot be good at small things, you will never be good at great things. Yes.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's a little bit like that. If you cannot appreciate your cup of tea, then your life won't be appreciated. So
But you know, amazing. sometimes it's hard to start from, okay, I have to make my cup of coffee or tea, like, you know, miracle. Yeah, it's hard at the beginning because
some people may think it's cheesy. It's hard cheesy to accept it on an intellectual level.
Sometimes you're thinking it's crazy, and sometimes you're thinking like it's all these manifestation states and something like that. Yeah, esoteric states, let's say.
Yeah, but actually, it's so simple. It's not about esoterics. I would say it's about the you know, in In Theta Healing, you have things called virtues. So, virtue of honor, virtue of courage. And this is virtue of admiration. So that you are capable, and not everybody is, as you said, admiring, kind of zachvit, yeah? Admiring simple stuff, yeah? Like the sunset, sunrise, I don't know, even rain, snow, whatever.
Yeah, but you know, in depression states, let's say, you can't do that. You know, it's somebody will tell you, okay, you have to make your tea better, yeah? Have
totally
a cookie,
agree.
You know, have a time for you and that. But in this rush, even not in depression state, but, you know, in let's say, normal state, yeah, of working like, you know, fight or flight mode, it's only another task for you. Like, okay, I have to do the tea,
okay,
so, you know,
I see your
like
point.
I should, because they said it will fix
it
me,
creates even more tension, yes.
Yeah, and it's
with tension, we get cortisol, with tension, we cannot heal, right? Do you confirm? Is that correct?
Yeah, but the solution is, you know, this tea is the, let's say, adult form of your body. And you can't get, you know, the target or the information from the adult part of the body, because that's the broken part. Yeah, we can say, oh, that's, you know, not informed part. So you have to, let's say, you know, make a step, not farther, but
step back
to the another state. Okay, maybe it will be in the, you know, in my palms. Yeah, something is in my palms. I can feel some, you know, sensation in the palms, but so different, you know, area of the life. Yeah, maybe I can you know, make something, some connection with the palms and lips. Yeah, and doing something like that, like kids do. Yeah, like
and start kind of
one,
enjoying.
Or maybe
like me in the party.
like me in the party eating, you know, all these snacks. Yeah, and you're putting this fingers to the mouth, and you know, you're touching this small heads, we can say, all this small achievo, and then something appears. Yeah, and after a few steps, after a few, let's say, pathways, you're connecting it to this state of this tea. Yeah, and
yeah, so you need to there is this beautiful word to graduate. Yeah, great. It's like going higher. So let's say the T is like graduating secondary school. Yes, so you need to go back to the basics.
Yeah.
Start with this. I even heard about a guy who was overweight or even obese, and he couldn't do any push-ups. He wanted to do push-ups, so he started. Well, he did one push-up maybe. So then, but then he didn't give up. He thought, okay, maybe I can go back to basics. And you know what he did? He started doing push-ups against the wall. And the one push-up, I don't know, per week, I mean, per day during a week. And then he added more and more. And then I think he, you know, those people, they basically end up running marathons always. so this kind of story, yes.
Yeah, that's going to the small steps, yeah, to the small bits, to the, you know, small neural awareness of the parts of the body, and I think it will always work, yeah, for people. Now, because but one problem is that people usually wish to have the results like, okay, if I do these exercises with my eyes or with my ears in neural awareness, I will fix this, and this, yes. But, you know, this machinery is so huge, let's say, this brain connection is so huge that you can improve your a small bit. And for example, you will not get this, let's say, the result you need, yeah? Like, I wish to be, I don't know, healthy, or I wish to be, I wish to don't have a spine problems, yes? Maybe you will start to don't having problems with the hips, and then it will evaluate in your spine, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so, because it's connected.
So the results are coming a little bit in the different, let's say, areas. We are still looking for this, you know, for this patterns that we can predictable and you know, like more to estimate, not estimate, but to get the result. Yeah, so pushing this button and something will change in your feet, for example. Yeah,
that must be hard to look for those connections.
Yeah, that will be hard because the the body is made by these embryos, yeah. So the your arm is, let's say, separate embryo, yeah. Your left, right arm, legs. So this appearance, if you take some level, this appearance will appear in all these levels, we can say, even in the brain, even in the eye, even in the mouth, every part of your body, but it's fractal, we can say, yeah. So you can't get the best result for, you know, from the direction to the let's say to the dot on the map, yeah. And it's not so simple, but it's working, yeah. And even we have more fun with that, because, you know, people like it was, for example, it wasn't a problem with my liver, it was a problem, for example, with my left knee or with the breathing situation, yeah, with the breathing exercises or breathing activation. And that makes me better, yeah, because, you know, it's really, really nice to have a people in the acupuncture rooms when you're reading the pulse, yeah, you're checking the area of the body, for example, liver, and they appears like I have few situations right like that. They appears in my rooms. I said, okay, this liver is really, really bad. We have to put this, and this. And I don't know, sending them the herbs or doing the one.
You do your magic, yes.
Yeah, I'm trying my best. And then they disappear because, you know, something happened. They can't came. They, you know, they delay the visit and stuff like that. But after a few months, you're getting to them. You're getting this pulse and it's much better, yeah. And I asked them, did you drink my herbs? No, I forgot. Yeah, they're on the shelf in the kitchen. Okay, what changed? Maybe it's the food, you know, maybe something happened, yeah. This pattern change in your body. And they said, you know, it was, for example, the situation that some worker just leave our company and we have, you know, relaxed mode, we can say, yeah. There was a small bit in this huge area that changed in the area, yeah? Like, for example, somebody is, I don't know, went out, yeah, or whatever, yeah. Change the working state or just, you know, disappear from their life.
So yeah? one piece of the puzzle.
Yeah, one piece of the puzzle changed. Yeah, so, that was a small, yes, a neural awareness, but in the huge, let's say, world, yeah. But it appears it's making changes in the liver, yeah, because, you know, it's much better. For sure, there are some patterns. And for sure, if this person will not get this information, okay, that was changing myself as well. They will get another person, you know, another wrong person today, to stimulate the liver, because there is a pattern of the, let's say, neurological pattern or physiological pattern. But if they get the knowledge, okay, if this person went out and, you know, disappeared from my life, and I feel better and I feel my liver is better, and the guy from the pulse is telling me, okay, the liver is better. If I catch that, I can, you know, I can a little bit change the another steps in my life. Yeah. For example, like, okay, last time I felt so better when that happened. So I will not get in this situation I'll have a different perspective for this situation.
Yeah. I just thought you unfriend half of the people on your Facebook.
Yeah.
I don't know. Where is the seat of jealousy, for instance? Where, liver as well? Where is jealousy located?
You know, I think
well, this thinking is not okay. This thinking is not accurate.
Yeah, it's not so accurate. There are some patterns for sure. The irritability will be in the liver, in the gallbladder, we can say, yeah. The weakness or maybe running thoughts will be from the heart or you know, the scare will be coming from the kidney and like that. But we have to notice that it can be from the kidney, but it can be from the microsystems as well. Like, you know, you had some knee injury, okay? Mm-hmm. You have some knee injury, you have some a lot of pain there, and this state of your body can go from there and, you know, go to the fractals, like, okay, from the knee to the liver, from the liver to the brain.
Okay.
So you can't, you know, target.
So this is, it flies over my head in the sense that too advanced for me to understand, but super, super interesting.
Yeah, so that's why neuro awareness, you know, making you going to this knee, going to this elbow, going to your body, and feel it better. So the communication is better, and you know, we can say that the brain is changing itself, yeah, as well.
Okay, kind of rewiring. So what would you advise on practical level, in the sense, try many neuro awareness exercises, just maybe you will, you know, hit the target, a little bit, like, you know, random, you know, approach, but still better than nothing.
We're trying to do some modules, like, you know, I wish to feel less heavy. Yeah, for example, mm-hmm. I wish to feel less scared in some scary situation. And we are trying to find a solution in our bodies, different kinds of, you know, bodies, different views of, because there are three of us.
Yeah, exactly.
Different views. Uh-huh. So every part of this, let's say, triple brain, making an exercise, yeah? And these exercises are some, let's say, fusion or some connection with this topic, yeah?
So do you find some similarities between your bodies, in the sense that what helps Oleg, for example, helps you, or,
you know,
vice versa?
It's funny situation, because sometimes it's that, my exercises, I feel okay. I don't wish to listen to my exercises, my voice. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's working much better. Yeah. Sometimes
I really love listening to my voice, to be honest.
Yeah, that's nice. That's nice. And sometimes it's in some topics, you know, I have to go outside. Sometimes in some topics I have to go inside, like only with my voice. Yeah. It depends on, really, I think, maybe on or from it's coming from the rhythm, it's coming from the tempo of the life or whatever. But what we notice that as well, that when we are doing the workshops, yeah, when we are doing the exercises, like, you know, in duet, yeah, in two persons, usually we are not connected about, we only know the topic, you know, but the results are really similar. And at the same time, we have the same exercises almost in our notes. You know what I mean?
Are you kidding me?
And,
okay.
And we have all the time this the same situation, like, okay, you choose mine.
You know what I mean? You stole from me.
You stole from me. How it's possible you get into the same sort, yeah? Uh-huh. And this sort is probably in the body. And that's why it's, you know, it's appearing like... We thought it will be in some maybe outside world, yeah. It mm-hmm. could be in some, I don't know, Akasha or whatever, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
State or Theta state or somewhere.
Actually, there. I have a comment here, but carry on.
Yeah, but I think it's coming from the body, because, you know, there are some body similarities, yeah, and you will get some similar patterns, yeah, of movement, similar patterns of thinking and stuff. Yeah, and this stuff, and I think it's coming from body. Maybe it's, you know, some higher resolution and some cosmic, let's say, energies, connection or information pole, how they say, and maybe, but this is the solution as well, mm-hmm. of the body.
Mm-hmm. So it made me think about this exercise that we did, because you can, let's say, heal your family. I mean, not only yourself using Theta. And heal the so-called spirit of the family.
Mm-hmm.
And we did the exercise, and then people started describing how this spirit of the family looked like in their, let's say, imagination, because it, I mean, a lot of people have simply visions in that mm-hmm. state. And many people were referring to a tree, an old tree or something like mm-hmm. that. And I was mm-hmm. like, I had the same, you know, and mm-hmm. that was amazing. So we found something in common. Despite being in different locations and seemingly not connected, so seemingly,
yeah.
I say,
yeah.
So the same probably happens to you. You are, of course, connected at some level, because you spend a lot of time together, I guess. But still, yeah. It's amazing to discover the same patterns, not the same patterns, but similar exercises.
Yeah, similar exercises. That's true. It's, you know, it's some higher intelligence, we can say, or some, you know, connection. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
You can't see it, but you can feel it. for sure, there are the intelligence of the group as well. Yeah. So if you in some group, it's making a chivo as well. So, you know, five person, one will be ahead, you know, left hand.
Organisms.
Yeah, for organism, for liver and in every company. Yeah,
this is also found in the language, for example, in business, you say the head of department. Yeah, the head of department.
Yeah, and the right hand.
Nobody talks about the liver of the department. It's a different story. The guy is always pissed off. Yeah,
liver will be probably the financial stuff.
Where's the money?
And you can find this in this resolution as well. Yeah, so I'm quite sure even in small groups, like, you know, few groups, like, I don't know, let's say Nordic walking groups or whatever, or some working groups, you will find this, you know, different pathways. You will find these different solutions. It will be a head, it will be an arm, and it will be other parts of the body. Yeah, and even you know, it's a high, let's say, level of thinking. But you can send even in going into the church. You're getting into the church. You are there, these, you know, roles. Yeah.
Well, but they used to be rather.
This church is as well the body of the, that's the body. Yeah, you know, you have the area of the, I don't know how to call it,
where the altar is.
The altar yeah,
is the head. Yeah,
it's altar is the head, and you have the views usually when the whole altar is, you know, this really beautiful, colorful fractals, I mean this vitrage. You have that, so you have vision in the head. You have the left arm, you have the right arm, like this.
Some sort of symmetry. It also forms a cross. Yeah.
Yeah, you can say the cross, and you as an energy, you as a people, you can say you're going through the legs. You're going from the, you know, main area, from the pelvic area.
From the base chakra, we can say.
Yeah, you can say from the base chakra, but the idea is that can't go farther than intestines. that's a tricky part.
Even the sound I produced when laughing was like intestinal. Yeah, like, I would say so. Yeah, we are the. So what do you think? We are treated like shit.
I think we are this. Microbes, bacteria. We are treated like a microbes for that.
But
we
they are super important. No bacteria, no life. But That's why probably church needs people. Yeah, needs
these bacteria and, you know, to. You can get the results as well and get the information. How is what is the connection between the head and the intestine in this area and this church? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's by voice, and sometimes it's by food. Yeah, because you're going for this.
The communion. What a deep thinking.
Mm. Yeah. So. I'm quite sure it's made like that, yeah, because, you know, they have the power of, let's say, of people.
Yeah, this
people,
is symbolic, yeah, a lot of symbolism, so I guess many, many things as well. But if we mention symbolism, so technically speaking, getting your communion is some form of cannibalism.
Yeah, you can say it's a cannibalism, and you can say you're going to the head, you're going to the mouth, because you're going to the part of the church where the, you know, mouth are speaking, to you.
And you get this, okay.
And in the same area, you're getting this, you know, part of of your body or whatever, And you can find a lot of similarities. And sometimes it's scary, like, okay, that's a programming tool for the person, you know what I mean?
But it's scarier than I thought, because, you know, I'm of course, when we talk, we've got new ideas, we create this some sort of intellectual and spiritual connection. But I got this idea that, you know, in public speaking, there are archetypes, and sometimes you've got this, for example, the CEO of a company or the boss who brings people to the training, he is the guy who feeds them. This is the guy who technically feeds them.
Yeah.
So whoever, just to connect it to church, whoever distributes the food has power.
Oh yeah, that's
so true. The priest is the guy that feeds you with something.
Yeah.
And no food, no life. Yeah, you are dependent on people or that give you food.
Yeah,
or the planet, you know, or whatever. But
If you wish to feel better there, if you wish to have some different perspective, you have to go into your own church, like your body, and next time
the temple. Yeah, that's why they call the body temple. Yeah, and yeah, temples are here as well. I don't know why, but
temporalis. Yeah. That's a temple as well. And if you have a look in your body, next time when you're going to the church, you will decide, okay, I am going to the large intestine in the left corner, you know, and sitting there and having fun, yeah. Maybe I will go to the liver side, maybe, yeah.
Yeah, I've never looked at this that way. So probably I will never look at the church, churches the same way, especially those built in.
You know, but on the other hand, have a look from the, for example, how the native Indians in America, how they connection will looks like. Yeah, it will be like, you know, fire in the middle, in some tipi, everybody around. Yeah,
you know, what I mean? Circular. And
yeah, there is a head for sure, but they're usually around that. Yeah, and there are some rings, we can say, you know, the ring number one, the ring number two. That's more similar to the low level of the, you know, of the, let's say, body, like, you know, cell. Yeah, it looks like a little cell, or maybe morula state, as we said in the Irish. Yeah, some patterns. There is the boss, we can say, for sure, but everybody almost on the same circle. Yeah. And the connection is better, much better, yeah, because it's direct, you know, connection from the middle, yeah.
And also, I don't know the culture, but I guess you don't have to stay in the same ring forever, because maybe children there are, for instance, in the third, fourth ring because of some reasons. But I believe this is a dynamic system where people can get closer with time, or maybe with merit, or
yeah.
But in church, I don't know if it can progress in this setting.
Yeah, that would be great. Yeah, that, you know, one time you are in the intestine, but the next time you are in the heart, and next time you are in the head. Yeah, that will be the.
Yeah, what I thought of, that you're never in the position of the head in church. Sometimes, some people read it, and okay. Yeah. But to be this head, I mean, well, you need to go through some training and restrictive training.
Yeah, that's a restriction. That's a restriction, and that's the disconnection with the body, really. Yeah, because you are only in the intestine. You are only
disconnected. Makes sense.
So you are only in this, let's say, consumption stuff. Yeah. But let's go to the bacteria state, yeah, and have fun in this bacteria state. You are the bacteria of the church, we can say.
Yeah, but what can we do as a bacteria?
Yeah, we can do a lot of, yeah. You can have a view of your own body, yeah, as a bacteria. Mm-hmm. And if you change this fractal, maybe the bigger fractal will change, yeah.
Oh, and for sure. Could you imagine all the bacteria changing their mind?
Yeah, I think, you know, this neural awareness is a great tool, because it's growing by itself. Yeah, like it's like a plant. Yeah, you're putting only the plant, the idea in the head, in the body, in the feeling, and it grows. Yeah, and in after a few months, you see the same person who've been on the, for example, your workshop, and they have their own workshops. You know what I mean? It's because this intelligence, let's say, or whatever awareness, making them so much improvement that they have to share with others. Yeah, and you know, it's like spreading the.
That's amazing. I hope. Yeah. So it's another branch of this tree, the positive tree of freedom, in a way, because. I think people getting more and more aware on different levels. So I think we'll have to wrap it up. Yeah?
Okay.
So any final thoughts, Michael? Any conclusions?
No, I think that was enough. Yeah, it's never enough. It's never enough, but, you know, let's feel free in our own churches.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah, I can do that. Amen.
Time to say goodbye.
Yeah.